Have you ever noticed how different foods affect your mood and focus? Maybe you felt energized after a balanced meal or sluggish after too much sugar. These aren't just passing sensations. They're real evidence of how food alters your brain chemistry. But what's really happening in your brain when you eat? And when might supplements be actually worth considering? I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I help you strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build resilience. In our last video, we explored specific supplements that can support memory. Today, we're taking a step back to understand the bigger picture, how the foods that you eat literally build your brain chemicals, and when supplements might help fill critical gaps. Your brain is incredibly complex as a chemical factory. Every thought, feeling, and decision depends on a delicate balance of chemical messengers called neurotransmitters. These neurotransmitters, like serotonin, dopamine, and GABA, influence everything from your mood and your focus, sleep, and stress response. But here's what many people don't realize. Your brain can't create these chemicals from nothing. It needs raw materials, specific amino acids, vitamins, and minerals to build these chemicals. And those raw materials come from your diet. This connection between nutrients and neurotransmitters is why what you eat has such a profound effect on how you feel and function. Different foods provide different building blocks for your brain chemistry. And when certain nutrients are missing or imbalanced, your brain chemistry shifts, affecting your mood, energy, and mental clarity. So let's break down how some of the most important brain chemicals are built from what you eat. First, there's serotonin, often called the feel-good neurotransmitter. It helps regulate mood, sleep, and appetite. Your brain builds serotonin from an amino acid called tryptophan, but it also needs several cofactors to complete the process: vitamin B6, iron, and magnesium. Foods rich in these building blocks include turkey, eggs, salmon, nuts, and leafy greens. When you eat these foods, you're giving your brain what it needs to maintain healthy serotonin levels, which helps stabilize your mood and promote feelings of calm and contentment. Then there's dopamine, the neurotransmitter of motivation, focus, and pleasure. Dopamine is made from the amino acid tyrosine, along with cofactors like B6, folate, and copper. Foods that support dopamine production include things like lean proteins, eggs, almonds, and bananas. If you've ever felt that burst of motivation and sharp thinking after a protein-rich meal, you're experiencing the effects of dopamine production in real time. On the other hand, when dopamine production is compromised, whether from poor nutrition or other factors, you might struggle with focus, motivation, or finding joy in activities that you usually enjoy. Another key neurotransmitter is GABA, which helps you feel calm and relaxed. GABA is made from glutamate, an amino acid that supports learning and memory. And it also needs vitamin B6 to complete the conversion. We're starting to see a pattern with these B vitamins. Foods that support GABA production include whole grains, lentils, and nuts, and also cruciferous vegetables like broccoli and cauliflower. And of course, we can't forget acetylcholine, which is important for memory, learning, and attention. Acetylcholine is built from choline, which is abundant in eggs, liver, and soybeans. If you're not consuming enough choline-rich foods, you might notice that it's harder to concentrate or recall information. I've been breaking down these nutrients individually, but it's important to understand that your brain doesn't process them in isolation. And this brings us to a key point here. Whole foods are nearly always a better source of brain-supporting nutrients than supplements. Why? Because whole foods contain complete nutrient profiles with natural cofactors and enzymes that help your body absorb and use these nutrients efficiently. For example, eating an egg gives you choline for acetylcholine production, but it also provides B vitamins, iron, and healthy fats that work together to support brain function. Additionally, many whole foods contain fiber, which feeds your gut microbiome, the trillions of bacteria that live in your digestive tract. And this is important because your gut microbiome actually helps produce many of the neurotransmitters that your brain needs. In fact, about 95% of your serotonin is made in your gut, not in your brain. So when you eat a diverse range of plant foods, you're feeding the beneficial bacteria that help synthesize neurotransmitters and maintain the gut-brain connection. This is one reason why processed foods, which typically lack fiber and micronutrients, can negatively affect not just your physical health, but your mental well-being as well. Now let's talk about brain energy metabolism, because this is another way food affects your brain function. Your brain is a very energy-hungry organ. Despite making up only 2% of your body weight, it consumes roughly 20% of your body's energy. And the primary fuel source for your brain is glucose, a type of sugar derived from carbohydrates that you eat. But not all carbohydrates affect your brain the same way. Refined carbs and sugars cause rapid spikes and crashes in blood glucose, which can lead to energy fluctuations in the brain. These fluctuations can manifest as brain fog, irritability, anxiety, or difficulty concentrating. On the other hand, complex carbohydrates like those in whole grains, legumes, and vegetables provide a steady, sustained release of glucose to your brain. And this gives you stable energy and helps maintain consistent focus throughout the day. Beyond glucose itself, your brain needs specific nutrients to efficiently convert that glucose into usable energy. And this happens in the mitochondria, often called the powerhouses of your cells. For your mitochondria to work efficiently, they need nutrients like B vitamins, magnesium, and CoQ10. Without those, your brain cells struggle to produce energy, which can lead to fatigue, poor focus, and burnout. This is the one case where certain supplements like CoQ10 or acetyl-L-carnitine can help support mitochondrial function, especially in people with chronic illnesses, fatigue, or age-related decline. Even if you eat a fairly healthy diet, certain groups of people are more at risk for deficiencies that impact brain function. Let's go through a few common examples. Vitamin B12 deficiency is common in older adults, vegans, and people with absorption issues. B12 is essential for focus, memory, and mood stability. Omega-3 fatty acids, especially DHA, are key for brain structure and anti-inflammatory function. If you don't eat fatty fish regularly, you might not be getting enough. Iron deficiency can impair oxygen delivery to the brain and lead to poor concentration and fatigue. And this can show up easily in women who have heavy menstrual periods. Magnesium is often depleted by chronic stress, alcohol, or diets high in processed foods. It helps calm the nervous system and supports brain plasticity. You also want to be cautious with overconsuming caffeine, sugar, and alcohol. These can all disrupt brain chemistry, deplete key nutrients, and increase your risk of emotional instability and sleep disturbances. So it's not just about what you're missing. It can also be what's interfering with your brain chemistry and your brain being able to absorb these nutrients. The most evidence-based approach is to use supplements when there's a clear nutritional gap that you can't realistically fill through food alone. And that might be because of dietary restrictions, increased needs due to your life stage, or a documented deficiency from lab testing. For instance, if you're following a vegan diet, vitamin B12 is a must because most plants don't naturally provide it. If you rarely eat fatty fish, supplementing with omega-3s can help support mood and brain cell structure. And if your labs show that you're low in iron or vitamin D, that's when vitamin D supplementation under medical guidance can be really effective. But food isn't the only factor. Certain life stages and conditions increase your brain's nutritional demands. Pregnancy, breastfeeding, aging, chronic stress, and chronic illnesses can all require additional support just to maintain optimal brain function. Medications can also deplete nutrients. For example, statins used to treat high cholesterol can lower CoQ10 levels, which your brain needs to produce cellular energy. And oral contraceptives can reduce B vitamins, magnesium, and zinc, nutrients that support mood, focus, and hormonal regulation. That's why supplementation is best used strategically, not as nutritional insurance or something to take just because it's trending. More isn't necessarily better. In fact, megadosing certain nutrients, especially without knowing your baseline, can sometimes cause more harm than good. If you're experiencing persistent brain fog, low energy, mood changes, or memory issues, it's worth talking to your provider about testing for common deficiencies. Even subtle imbalances in vitamin B12 and vitamin D, iron, or magnesium can have a big impact on how your brain functions day to day. Ultimately, your brain chemistry is built on food. Whole foods provide the foundation, but for some people, depending on your diet, stress level, medical history, or medications, targeted supplementation can offer the extra support that your brain needs to function at its best. In our next video, we'll explore some of the newer supplements marketed for brain health, things like nootropics, adaptogens, and smart stack combinations. There's a lot of hype in that space, and I'll help you sort through what's helpful, what's hype, and how to think critically about these options. So if you haven't already, make sure that you've subscribed and hit the notification bell so you don't miss this one. Thanks for watching today. I'll see you in the next video.